guys to our interview number 3 with this beautiful guest, our friends William and Paloma, originally from Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. We're very happy to have them talk to us today about competition, their experience, and I'll just introduce them very quickly, just a little bit. Paloma is from Rio de Janeiro. She started dancing bolero, samba, soltinho, and Brazilian zouk in 2008. She has graduated in journalism. William, he's also from Rio de Janeiro. He started dancing in 2006 at Alexi Carvalho, Centro de Dança Alexi Carvalho, and they started dancing together in 2011. They won their first competition. They won a competition in 2012, which was the 3rd International Zouk Congress, also in Rio de Janeiro. But actually, that wasn't their first time competing. So we want to know, how was that first experience competing? So you want to say, like, who competed first? How was it for you?
Talking about only dance, I compete. My first competition was with Juliana Magalhães, was a friend of mine as well, and was a partner from Rafael Oliveira, one of my teachers. So I danced with her at the same competition you just said right now. I danced at the first edition of the competition, and we got the second position
on that 2010, competition. Right?
2010, exactly. Because this competition was by two years. My first partner was Daniela Verglis, that was a partner with Alex Carvalho. That was my first dance partner ever. And then I just moved to Londrina. When I come back, she was dancing already with Alex. And then we invite Juliana to dance with me and train. Rafael was training us and preparing us for the competition. So it was a very cool time for me.
And then in 2011, you guys start dancing together and you competed first time together, right? How was that first competition together?
It was really, really heart crazy for me, because at this moment I was just a bassista, just a student, you know, and William...
It's like a student supporter, right?
Yes. So William already has experience at this time already, teaching, right? But for me, everything was new, was crazy, but was amazing. I was really excited about everything, about dancing, about the training that we had. It was really short, really, really short time, because we just know about the competition in July, and the competition was in August. So less than 1 month, we get prepared for this competition in Brasilia.
What made you think like, okay, oh, we have 1 month, but yeah, let's do it. We want to do it. Why? Like, why didn't you think, oh, no, it's too short of a time. I guess we should wait.
At that time, we didn't have, we didn't have much life choice, right? Or we risk, let's say like this. Because as you know, like, our situation in Brazil, that time, especially my situation, was not the best situation ever. I was still like, need some help supporting kids, like money and stuff. So I was working, start to teach, so I get a little bit of money so I can keep supporting my own studies. You know, my family couldn't really support as much as they could, but they couldn't do much. So we decided to do it because I thought that this would pump us up, would push us up. And especially as well, because Rafael Oliveira, he supported us a lot. He helped us on the trainings, and he said like, oh, let's do this. Not at this first competition, but at the second, he helped us more. But anyway, he always support me. He always say, come on, William, do it. You do it because you're going to be able to do it.
You know what I love? What I love about Rafael is that, because Rafael, he's like, you don't have a choice. He's like, guys, there is a competition, it's this date, we're doing it, that's it. And I love that he inspire people and he support, yeah.
He's so good in, like, making people believe in themselves. Rafael, for me, it's the best in it. It's the best in it. Because we look back on the Alex Carvalho School, for example, and those dancers, that was like, the dancer that people don't trust much that they're gonna be a dancer, you know? Rafael made them be a dancer, and they are amazing right now. You know, like, yeah. Just because of this, it's a mind thing, you know.
No, it's a talent. Like yesterday, we were talking to Paulo and Luisa, and we talk about the importance of having a coach. Now, every now and then, you need to have someone to train you from outside. But it's not just to train you; it's actually to make you keep going and to push you, to inspire you, to support. Some coaches, like, because Luisa is more of a ballet style, that she likes the hardcore. And I think Rafael has this a little bit, but he's more of a, like, he inspires you. He manipulates you, right? In a good way,
yes. That's also for me really important because, for example, at this moment, actually, I still have this feeling that I'm not so into it, competition. But I really admire all the process, you know. It's really important for the dancer as a challenge, because when we have an objective, it's much easier to follow on one way. But it's also important to keep your mind in a healthy way, you know, during all the process. And it's important to have someone to support you, not just your partner, because, for example, William supports me all the time on it. Like, he keep pushing me during the process, and was amazing because changed my dance a lot. I would say, like, these two competitions, like, change in a huge way my dance, and in so fast way as well. Both process, you know, both trainings for the both competitions was crazy.
Listening to you guys talking about Rafael and all this is really nice, because I had that experience with him too, with Alex as well, so I really understand. It's like, those guys, they are great. But apart from Rafael and all those people that help you guys into the competition, do you remember what inspired you guys to start competing? Apart from this,
then I have to tell you that I have been always competing. So since I was born, my family teach me to compete, to fight for what I want, and to go hard on it, you know. And if I really want that, then go serious on that. So for me, go serious on that and go like 100%. It's enjoy all the aspects of it, you know. So for example, I was competing in judo. I compete in judo when I was young, I compete in volleyball, I compete in football. So every sport I tried, I went for a competition. So when I start to dance, then what I gonna do? I gonna search for a competition as well, you know? Because for me, this is the way I can prove myself, for me, that I am able to grow and hit the places that I'm wish to be, you know, like that I'm really focused on some objective. So since I was born, since I was young, I always fight, I always compete on every sport I did. And I think dance was just one more sport at that time when I was young that I want to compete and I want to go hard, because I know that this is gonna give a big improvement to my soul, to my dance, to myself as a person as well. Because every time you challenge yourself and you do this step up on the stairs, it makes you feel good, even when you fall, because then you come back harder, you know? So for me, compete, it's what pushed me, what keep me going, you know?
So, yeah, and I'm completely different. And I think this is a good example for people understand that sometimes a partner can be completely different, but they can complement each other. In my way, for example, my childhood, when I was teenager, I was really into it just with the books, you know, like most of the time. But and then when I start to dance, completely changed my way of life, changed my passion, my motivation, you know. So and then when I accept to compete with William, was just because I love dance, you know. At this moment, I didn't have any background about competition. I didn't have the anxious or the wish for win something, you know. I just want to enjoy the process, to dance, to live this in a maximum way. I can say this for sure, guys, because I think William just like invite me because he saw that on me, like, oh my gosh, she's crazy, she love dance.
I saw the love in your eyes. I saw that you love what to dance, and I think I thought you could explore even more your potential. That's what I thought.
You know, at this moment, I didn't have, oh my gosh, I want to win, I want to do that. Not in this way, but it's also okay because he support me and I support him on what he wants because we both have the same love, you know, the same passion. So it's...
I think that's what is cool that you just mentioned, like you compliment each other. This is very, very good because like some people, they have this feeling like, oh, but I wasn't born like that. Like I was trained to compete as well because my ballet background, contemporary background, and those dance, you know, it's like a sport. You train to compete and then you want to win, of course. And then, and like William just is a fighting for life as well in a way. So sometimes we don't have the competition set, as in there is a competition thing happening, organization, but you are always competing really, right? For to improve, right? To do your best and stuff. So even though Paloma thinks like, even though you said like, oh, I didn't have this mentality, but then in the process of working and being a professional, you have to have that in mind, correct? Like you, and then William pushes you to just like keep this motivation, right?
But at the beginning, this is one thing that I many times share with the people for they know, is like, at the beginning, when we started to dance, when we started to compete, he already has this mentality of being a professional. He's already a professional. But when he invited me, I'm not a professional, and I didn't have at the first moment the idea of become a professional, you know. Everything actually runs really fast for me, and then of course he prepared me, he teach me, he trained me for not just be a dancer but be a teacher as well. But at the beginning I didn't know, you know, I really don't know.
So then you did the competition and then you placed second. That was your first time, you barely trained. Like, that was awesome. That was very, very, that was very impressive. And then what made you think, okay, next year we're going to do it again?
Really can say.
I can say that. I can make, what makes me do the next year was the fact that I get the
second
position.
He still wants the first.
You know? Because.
He still wants the first.
I always want the first position. I don't get crazy if I get the second, the third, the last. I don't get crazy with that. That shows me which kind of level I am for myself right now or for the world right now. So it gives me some idea which case, like, how should I improve? If I go too low, if I get too low, that means that I'm really wrong. I should change a little bit what I am learning, what I'm studying. If I get close there, it means that I'm going right. Keep going this way. You're going to get there, you know? So I don't mind getting last, first, third, second.
Yeah, I think that I will mention this again. I mentioned this yesterday on our interview with Paul and Luisa. Something Karine said that I'll bring that on and on is that when you compete, when the whole process that Paloma said is very interesting, is very good. I appreciate the process to compete. It's so important. It's so good for your improvement, right? I mean, the maximum is going to happen. So if you get last place in the competition, you see, the worst thing that can happen is the improvement you're going to get from it. So it's not bad at all. It's all beneficial, right? Because all is going to happen to you, you're going to improve. So I love that when she said that. I'm like, gosh, this is it. Yeah,
you always win something, especially if you get like experience, you know? You just can't know what you feel when you get there at the place. and you didn't have the experience, you cannot get this for yourself.
So, with all this, tell us, how did the competition change your career?
I think the competition changed a lot our career, because give us a lot of visibility in our partnership. Because when everything started, when we won the first place in the Renata Pessanha's competition, we just had 2 years of a partnership. We was really, really young in our partnership, but actually the result give us a lot of visibility, not just this one, but I think already when we get the second place in Brasília also give us visibility. Because when we go through 2012, we already have some invitations to do workshops in other cities in Brazil.
Yeah,
as well,
I think I think it changed our career in the fact that we improve a lot and we get ready to work with that. Okay, what I mean? I mean that it doesn't matter if you get first position 3 times, but if you're not ready to the world, if you're not ready to teach, yeah, if your body is not ready to absorb the informations, you're gonna get there and you're gonna disappear, let's say like that. So I'm happy that the competition it doesn't give only the place for us and the visibility, but it gives us knowledge and experience where we were able to share better this experience and this knowledge once we get that visibility. And I think visibility plus the experience was the 2 points that really changed the competition, help us and change us to a different level to really start to go to the world and teach.
It prepared you, no? It prepared for the world. That's all. That's awesome. What was a funny moment during a competition that you remember? It could be like a Jack and Jill or a choreography competition.
Funny moment? Well, funny moment. It depends. It depends which kind of funny moment.
I would say like really quickly about this, but then one of my competitions, I just fell off on the floor with my head, and it was really hard. But at this moment now, it's fun for me. Not at this moment, but now it's fun. But now it's okay. It's also experience.
Do you? And it was a Jack and Jill, no?
It was a Jack and Jill.
Funny one that I had was in Jack and Jill as well, and I was training my partner. I think was here on the shirt. And the shirt just start to roll into my
finger. Oh my gosh.
Then I stopped her and I start to turn opposite.
It happened with us many times.
You know, like to take off my finger. That was funny.
That's crazy. That's funny. You know, those things, like the thing Paloma mentioned as well, I think, like, for example, watching that video, it's a little accident, and now it's funny, you can tell people and laugh about it, but you also prepare you so much for what could possibly happen, and how is going to be your recovery. We talked about yesterday how important it is to have a very good, fast recovery, especially when you're out there. You are competing. Jack and Jill is even, I think, harder because it's improvised, so then you still need to get up. You still need to, boom, get into it. The music's still playing. No one's going to stop, no? So that's important.
When I saw my video from this competition, I didn't remember when I stand up and I keep dancing. I didn't remember at all, but the adrenaline and, like, the memory on my body give me the energy to keep going, you know? I didn't decide this, but my body and my mind decide for myself.
Well, but those are things that is just gonna happen. For example, a car accident just happened with who is inside of the car, you know, like who is driving car. So if you don't do, or not really, if you cross the street as well. But if you are not risking, if you are not dancing, this kind of accident is not gonna happen. So that means that just the fact that you are dancing, you will need to be prepared for any accident that can happen.
For everything.
So yeah,
okay. So many accidents. Sometimes the people think that these things don't happen to us. Accidents, no. What? It happens all the time.
I never fell. Everybody
never fell. Well, everybody fell.
It happened even often with us, than with the students, for example, because we are practicing often and often.
More.
So we do more mistakes. We do much more things. Yeah.
Exactly. So I think it's really cool for us to always say that. I remember in my time with ballet that I used to watch some videos from people that inspired me, some amazing ballet dancers. One of them, Sylvie Guillem, and I found this video of her, and the title of the video say, Sylvie Guillem is a human. And I'm like, why does it say that? I mean, she's not a human. I thought, she's not a human. Why are they saying she's a human? So I go watch the video, and she tripped, she slipped on her legs on her point, and she goes down, and I'm like, whoa. So it is awesome though, because you think, wow, she's still so amazing, and she gets up and kill it. And that's the best thing, the recovery. That's why we talk about the judges, right? When we do judges training, and we say, it's so important the judges watch that recovery moment. That can be a lot better than anything else.
Talking about recovery moment, many people know this story because it was a huge event. It was a big congress, and talking about recovery. You know, Salsa Open in São Paulo, right?
Oh,
was in the big hotel, was amazing. And I was used to go there every year with Alex Carvalho Company and everything. And then I was dancing a samba choreography with Carlos Oliveira. It was Carlos Oliveira and Raquel. And I was dancing with Daniela Veglis.
Daniela.
I was dancing with Dani. You know what happened with me in the middle of the dance? A blackout. I was sick for the week, and I think I forced my body too much, and I blacked out, and I just fell.
Oh my gosh! I remember.
I fell, like, boom, like a statue, boom.
Crazy. Now changing the fun side to the a bit serious side. Not really serious, but I mean, in your opinion, for you to. Why dance competitions are important for the dance community?
The same reasons why it's important for me. It makes grow. And I think if we use the competition, as I said, I use the competition to understand how I am growing. If I'm growing well, if I'm growing wrong, if something is not working well, and I can get good feedbacks. And I can just move to another way if I'm going wrong, you know, and I can really improve myself. So I think dance without competition, if we have just dance without competition, we're gonna be just a small group, let's say like that, because the competition makes grow not only yourself, but makes attracting more people into this group because they wanna improve too, they wanna get the point as well. And many people, as Larissa already said at the beginning, just the fact that we are alive, we are competing. Even if you don't use the word competing, if you have a regular job, you are competing with your friends there to have a good job for the boss don't kick you out, you know. So you are competing anyway. If you don't use the word competition, but you are trying to be the best in that company, you know? So I think it's good to be ambitious. And this little bit of ambitious that we have helps to grow and helps to attract more people, because people likes to be around ambitious people, because usually are those people that are growing a lot. So I think it's gonna help to grow the community, it's gonna help to grow the quality of the dance, and it's gonna help each person to understand more or less what should I do, what's my next step to evolve. How many people just don't know what to do? You know, sometimes I get this level. I get on the level that I think like, what should I do now to improve, to go a next step? And I sometimes I don't know, and I'm searching for. Well, competition gives you this straight away.
Yeah, just want to add in the same perspective, this. It's important to give the people the opportunity. Sometimes they don't know, as William said. And when you give a nice competition with a good judge, everything organized, this make people to take it serious, you know? Not just for themselves, but for all the people that participate in the competition. So this opportunity to challenge themselves, to ask for more information, helps on the process of growing the dance. And the growing the dance, it's also good for competition, for the dance life, as a teacher, as a student, everything. So everything are connect.
Yeah, that was one of the biggest reasons why, for example, I just compete, this year I compete in bachata, right? I competed at the beginning of the year before start all the pandemic and everything. I just competed in bachata, professional category, and I was scared. I was scared because it was a new thing for me, it was a challenge for me, and I'm happy I did. I'm very happy I did, because I compete in two categories with the two different choreographies. One category, basically, there was not much more competitors, so I get first position straight away by the points. And the main category that we want to go for, we get the third position on that category. And for me, it was a good point as I start Zouk and I did a competition. I want to know how people are looking to me or how I am improving myself. I want to do the same in bachata and as well to connect the communities and for other people be able to see our dance and see us as a competitors as well. Yeah, no, but we'll get the point and for sure we get a high level, because in Zouk we are good dancers. We have a good level of dancers. We have a lot of material about body movement, so it will be very attractive for many other dancers. And as well, I think a lot. You know me. I always talk about you about competition because you know I love competition as well. So I'm as well preparing things that later gonna be talking with you too, because I want maybe to connect and do some other thing for we have even more possibilities and we spread even more this competition energy, but in this good way, that competition is just to make the community and yourself as well to grow. It's not, oh, okay, I don't like competition, because people confuse competition with fighting. It's different, you know. You compete, you don't, of course, you are fighting for what you want, but not in the bad way. You're not aggressive with anybody. You know, you just wanna dance and show what you do the best, right? So,
guys, we're getting to the very end now, but the important question I would like to ask you guys: what advice would you guys give to the Zoukers that never competed before, that want to start competing?
Didn't did competition yet, right?
Never competed before. Yeah.
Never competed before. The first advice is, don't be afraid, don't be scared to compete. Because when we say the word competition, sometimes you get afraid, right? You get scared, like, oh no, I don't want to compete, oh my gosh. No, don't be afraid, because as we all said here at the beginning, competition just gonna give you improvement. There's not all the thing that competition would give you always improvement. Then train harder as you can, as much time as you have, train. Usually I train not only dance, but I prepare my body as well when I go to competition. So usually I do gym at least 2-3 times a week. It's good to have your body prepared. I don't mean be a extraordinary strong person, no. It's
bodybuilder.
it's not like that. I just wanna have my body, my breath ready, you know, to the competition, because that will be a lot of pressure, a lot of things from outside. And of course you need to breathe well, you need to have your body in a good condition that you can support to dance with other people watching you. It looks like a bullshit, but I do the same choreograph when I'm training, I do on the stage, But in the stage, it's a 3-4 times much harder than when I do on the training. So I lose my breath sometimes, I'm tired, and I'm like, oh my gosh, my body's shaking. So then, if you prepare your body, training your body as well, more with cardio exercises, even more than weight, more cardio exercise, you're gonna be much ready, and you're gonna breathe better, and you're gonna be ready to react if you need to react fast. Okay, so feel your body ready is very good, and dancing as well, at least 2 times a week. And right now that I can do this advice as a pass to this 1 month training, never do 1 month training for a competition. Okay, never do 1 month training for a competition. We were training every day like crazy, and we were not prepared 100% the way we wish on our first competition. So prepare yourself for a competition in 1 month, it's impossible. Okay, you're gonna get there and you're gonna do so like I did.
Just before Paloma, we have, so for next year for Brazilian Zouk World Championships, we have so many divisions as well. You have like, we have Pro-Am, which if you never competed before, you can ask your teacher to choreograph something with you and compete with you. And that could be a way of inspiring you and helping you to feel less nervous because you have your teacher. Well, some people feel more nervous, but some people feel less nervous. Where Pro-Am for Zouk, it's a very new type of competition. There's a lot of Pro-Am competitions in the ballroom world, West Coast Swing, Salsa, Bachata, but for us it's new. So just like, so you know, you're competing with your teacher and you are the only one being judged. Your teacher will help you create this routine. We're gonna have Jack and Jill, we're gonna have Strictly Zouk, which it's like a Jack and Jill, but you get to choose your partner, so you sign up with a partner. And then we have the professional divisions, right? We have amateur division as well, so it's your first time and you don't feel like, oh, I'm not a professional, but I would like to do a little routine and compete. Yes, come, do amateur. And then we have Showtime, which is a professional that has acrobatics, and the original, which is the professional that doesn't have any lifts, no lifts at all, lifts are not allowed. So I think there's so many opportunities, right, for you to choose, like, what would be the best category?
Yeah, you're gonna find the one that fits better for what you were searching in the competition as well. Because as we say, competition just gonna give you improvement. And if you don't feel ready to compete with lifts and all days and that, you can choose a competition that fits better for yourself right now. Maybe in the future you're gonna change the category or change which style of competition you are going for because you feel much ready for that. So try to search for the competitions that you, the categories that you feel that it gonna gives you much more than frustrate you. Of course, if I just started dancing and I wanna go to a professional competition, of course I'm gonna get frustrated because I'm gonna see my dance in front of the other dancers and I'm gonna feel bad, you know? So try to fit your dance, what you think, which kind of category it will be better for you, choose that and go for it. Don't be afraid, train your body, train your dance, and enjoy the moment. It's so good. It's so good and it's so quick. Enjoy the moment.
Yeah, remember that we all feel frustrated in some moments of our career as well, with or without competition, and we need to use this frustration as well, right, to make sure it helps us continue, like, progressing and keep going. Amiga, just to finalize, can you give advice for the people that compete? They already competed before, they did amateur here and there, or they did a few Jack and Jill competition and they really want to compete. And then an advice for the people that, like, they don't want to compete, but I mean, I always say you should come and support the people competing, you know?
So first, for the people already compete, right? So my advice is to take, as we said before, every experience, every competitions for yourself. Doesn't matter the result, because we always can get a different experience, but not just experience, like the way you deal with your sensations, with yourself, with your partner, with the moment. So we never know until we get there. So when you get there, sometimes we get more nervous. Sometimes we get like chill and nice. And it's okay. Every moment will be different. So we need to enjoy that difference. It's not because on my last competition, get the first place, everything was nice, that I need or I supposed to expect for the same for the next competition, you know? We need to actually to ask for the difference, for and then we can deal much better every moment. Other thing that I can advise is more you be more aware with your body, with yourself, we can support our partner as well. Because sometimes we are too focused on ourselves and the result we want, and sometimes we didn't pay attention in our partner. It's a good moment to build the relationship or with your partner or just with your partner in this right moment, for example, in Jack and Jill. Now, for me, this is also really, really important. Other thing that I like to say, I didn't have this thought when I started, it's a moment for if you never compete or if you already compete, it's time for you open your mind, you know. You can see a lot of videos, you can talk with the people, they already have more experience than you. So I didn't have this at the beginning, but if I started right now, and we have so many opportunities to get information, you know, to talk with the people. Now it's so much easier to just go and I love this about, because you can improve and increase your creativity. What you can do different with yourself, with your partner, with your work.
Yeah, I like to watch a lot of videos of the last winners, of the last second places, third places, because I know what the world expected, what they like the most. So I get inspired by those videos as well, and I can try to go more or less on the line that it looks for me, the line that people like the most, you know, like, oh, this guy won here and he dancing this way, that guy won there and they dance pretty similar and blah blah blah, you know. So I connect more or less which kind of lines of arms, lines of legs, which kind of body movements the judges accept more on that dance style. That's what basically I did, for example, on bachata as well, and I think you guys have done as well on West Coast Swing, right? So you watch the videos and you want to understand what the judges like the most, what they are searching for as well. So this will make you feel much more prepared for the moment, because you're gonna feel that you're bringing to them what they expected to see as well, you know. So I felt much better, much more confident with my choreograph, because I know I create my choreograph based in the world that I already, the competition world that I already saw.
And one last thing about, for example, for the people never compete, and for example, I'm not prepared to do a lift. I say, like, I would never know if I'm prepared or not if I didn't try, you know. So before you say no to yourself to do something, try first, you know. Try with a professional beside you, you know. Always try to give a nice and a health place for you do our movement, you know. Especially if you want to do a lift, for example. Try to do in a healthy way with a professional, but try. Don't say no straight away. Yeah.
Yeah. And now they don't need it, because we have the amateur division, which can be with Litsa or not. And we have the regional divisions that is no Litsa. So if you don't feel, because some people really, they get scared, right? So, and some people feel, oh, I must do a lift to compete or to choreograph or to even perform. No, you must not. Definitely not. So can give it a try, and if you feel scared, you don't need to, right?
Yeah, you can compete on what, as I say, you can compete on what is best for you, in what you would feel comfortable. If you don't feel comfortable with lift, search for a competition that has no lift. I don't feel good, I don't know, dancing with partner, I prefer to dance alone. There is as well competition that you can dance by yourself, you know. So you're gonna find different categories, and for sure you're gonna find one that fits for your, for what you wish, for what you want.
Right.
Nice. Well, guys, we're getting into the end. I would like to say a big thank you to you guys again for being with us and to give all this advice and tell us a little bit about you two.
Thank you so much.
I saw you guys growing internationally, and I need to say another thank you to you both, because you guys helped and still helping a lot the dance community in every single way. The dance should say a big thank to you both for everything you guys brought to the zoo community and still giving. Also, we are very good friends, and I really admire you guys as a dancers, as a teachers, as a performers, and, you know, especially as a friends as well. So thank you so much for everything, for being here with us, Jesus. Yeah, buddy.
Well,
thank you,
yeah, I would like to say thank you, because you two, you know, you guys inspire us a lot. You remember back there in Ilha do Zouk, where I was watching your rehearsal. I was watching your rehearsal, and I just was crying.
I was crying. just watching the rehearsal.
Then I went to talk with you guys. I said, like, oh my God, it was so good to see you guys alive. Because I remember Kadu very little when I was young, and he's still in the school. Then he moved out to Australia, and just like maybe a year after I get into the school. So for me, it was great to have this connection with a person that I admire, and especially to see that those people, they are humans as well. They are human as well, and they are very friendly and amazing person, and that gives me much more motivation, because then I found the exactly place where I want to be. I want to be at that moment, I want to be like you guys. I want to be amazing in what I do. I want to do amazing performance. I want to be amazing teacher, and I want to be an amazing person with my students, with my people, with my community. So you guys showed that to me at that moment, and that was a huge inspiration for myself. If Willian is here today, you guys have got not one, two fingers.
Thank you so much. That's really sweet. Thank you. That's awesome.
And be your friends now is just a
I just want to add, because William say everything was at the beginning for me. I just knew Kadu and Larissa by video. So at the beginning, they just as my idol. They still my idol, but now it's an honor to have a friendship with you guys, to work with you guys. It's always an honor to be in the same stage, to be in the same event. Like, you guys not just inspire, but you guys always give a support, not just for us as a friend, as a professional, but you give a lot of support for all the people that is started in the community, for the students, for everyone. So this is also somewhat inspired for myself. I want to be this kind of professional that it's support everyone, you know, like it's really friendly and accessible. So thank you so much. Love you so much. Love you guys. Love you.
Obrigada, amiga. Que bom.
Pô, obrigado a você. Vocês realmente foram uma inspiração
obrigada,
incrível,
gente.
Hein?
Obrigada de coração, gente. Love you too.